Hey everybody, it's Carl Brown from GuitarLessons365.com, and today I thought I'd talk about a little bit of how to mute the unwanted strings while soloing. So we all know that half the battle of playing guitar is not only playing the notes that you want to be heard, but also muting all the other strings. So I'm going to talk about how I kind of do muting and how I approach it and how I see a lot of players. There's more than one way to mute. I'll talk about a couple of them here. But I'll kind of show you really what my main method of keeping the rest of the guitar quiet while you're just playing, say, notes on one string. So first of all, it's going to deal with the base of your index finger on your fretting hand and the base of your palm in your picking hand. Okay, so let's talk about what's doing what in this kind of equation. So I'm going to start here on just on the fifth fret here on the sixth string. Now when I'm playing a note on the sixth string, now I'm doing this with a lot of distortion because it's really when a lot of these notes are really hard to, can really create a lot of noise while you're soloing. So when I'm playing in, on the sixth string, everything, every other string is muted by the side of my index finger. So it kind of, it's just holding pressure down on the top string here. And then it's just lightly touching all the other strings. So now they're muted. So if you could just put a little bit of finger pressure, you don't want to push it down so it's, you're actually playing those notes. You just have that note ringing and the other ones are muted. So when you play the other, so I'll play like a chromatic line here. That thing's done, that finger's done, but it's still muting all the other strings and keeping them quiet, all right? Now, as we go across strings here, this is when it gets a little bit interesting and a little bit tedious, depending on how you want to look at it. When I go to the next string, what I'm doing is I'm still muting every string below the string that I'm playing with the base of, or the side, the edge of my first finger. But the string directly above, so now the sixth string, the way I place that first finger on the string, I let it go just above the string and touch the bottom of the string just above it. So that sixth string is now muted as well, and so is the fourth through first strings. And the fifth string is the only one that's being heard. So that's a little bit, will take a little bit of getting used to. It's just how you place that first finger just over the string. Make sure you don't land on the sixth string. You're just under it, and you're basically touching the underside of the string. Just like that. Just touching it, just barely touching it. And that'll keep it from ringing out when you're not playing on it. Because just the natural motion of you playing guitar is going to cause the other strings to vibrate if you're not muting them in some way. All right, so let's keep going. Let's go to the fourth string. So this is where now we're going to be incorporating the right hand palm. So what we have here is obviously the first string is still, the first finger is still muting all the strings beneath the string I'm playing, and the string directly above it is once again being muted. But now I have this sixth string here. And what you're gonna do here is you're gonna use the base of your palm right around the edge, just the base around the thumb muscle and around the pinky muscle, and lay that down across the strings, about right where the strings meet the bridge. Lay them right on the strings. So we have... So the only thing you heard in there was the fourth string. And now the right hand palm is muting that lower string. So when I move to the third string, I will have the first... I'm playing the third string, I'm muting the first and second string with the underside of my index finger, and the fourth string with the tip of my index finger. And now the fifth and sixth strings will be muted by the palm down here. Now the reason why I'm muting this right here, the string just above it, is because a lot of times it's very difficult to get that close to it with your right hand palm without muting the note that you're actually playing. It's a bigger area here to control. So a lot of times it's easier just to use the tip of your finger to mute the string that's right adjacent to the one that you actually want to be heard. And then the other ones can be taken care of with the palm, since it's they're far enough away you don't run a big risk of muting out the string that you're actually playing. So that's kind of the process. It just continues as you work across. Now a big thing here when we're soloing, we do bends. Now, bends can cause a few problems with muting. First of all, what really want to kind of concentrate on is when you do the bend, first of all, you're going to be usually probably using two fingers. Like say, the finger that most people bend with is the third finger. So if I was going to bend here at the 15th fret, and I'm supporting it with the finger right behind it, and what I'm going to do with the first finger is, once again, it's going to be muting the string just above it, and it also mutes the strings underneath. It's kind of curved, but you can still get it to mute everything. Okay? And what happens is, it's muting where you push up the strings, because you'll notice, if I didn't mute that, now listen to this. So if I let go of that bend, those strings that I was pushing into are now going to ring. So we need to keep those quiet. And you can keep those quiet with a combination of the index finger going right behind it and holding that string, those strings still as you come back down, and also using the palm down here for the strings that are higher up, okay? All right, so it's just these little concepts here that you need to pay a lot of attention to. There are some guitar players that choose not to really mute too much with the underside of their first finger when they're doing soloing. They like to keep the finger arced, and if you do that, you need to use the fingers, these three, like the extra three fingers on your hand, to mute the upper string. So I'd be playing like around the fourth string here, and I have these fingers, each one laying on a string here. The top three strings, the lower strings are being taken care of by the palm, and the upper strings, since I'm arcing the first finger now, are being muted by these fingers. That's a little bit more difficult, especially when you're doing some fast runs, to keep those fingers still and do the muting with those. But there are some players, and I will do it occasionally too, if I need to mute those strings, but I got something going on down here that I can't necessarily flatten out that first finger like that. And if you're wondering, this isn't just for soloing. When you're doing chords, like if we're doing power chords, that's still muting all those strings that aren't going to be heard here with my first finger, the index finger. And when I come over to the fifth string, I'm still muting the sixth string with the tip of, just muting it by touching the bottom of the sixth string with the tip of my first finger. I have the three strings down that I'm playing, and then the first and second strings here are being muted just by lightly laying on them with the first finger. So it's all about just a little bit of positioning, and it's a little bit pressure here, putting the right amount of pressure on it so you're not holding down a string, you're just touching it enough to keep it from vibrating. All right, so what I would recommend is go through, do your basic technique exercises that you do every day. Something like that, like we did in this video, and make sure the finger placement stays the same. Get used to when the fingers, the palm comes into play, and when these, and how you mute, you place that first finger on there just correctly to mute the string right above it. And then eventually it just becomes a natural way of playing, and you can just really control the sound of the guitar, which is obviously very important. Okay, so I hope some people found this lesson useful, and please go to guitarlessons365.com and request more lessons, and I will see you guys again really soon. All right, bye-bye.